For deleting user, we have created function delete user. Now we have called this dot get writable. That means we want to remove a data, so I'm using get writable database as a function. So this is inbuilt function we are calling. Now db.delete. So delete is a method, insert is a method, update is a method. So these are the methods we have to call. We have to give the table name and we have to give the column values. So like this, we want to call a delete method and the value of the column 1, and that value is provided by using a parameter username, and after that db.close. So this is the method to delete a user from the database. Now the last function, that is list of user and get all users. So we have to create a class, another class, that is user class. So inside the user class we have to provide username and password as the string values, and after that we want to use getter and setters. So public string get username, this is the getter, and set username, this is the setter. So this is the Java class. We have to provide a getter and setter for the user class. Now this class is called over here. So list of user, it is going to return the list having a type as a user, and the value is get all user. Now here you can fetch the column values. Now string of columns is equal to column 1 and column 2. So these are the column values we want to retrieve, and this is set in the string columns. Now string sort order ascending, I want the ordering of the values should be in the ascend order, so you can put up the ascend order. After that, list of user list is equal to new array list. I want to store this into the array list of type user. So this is a data type. So user is a data type having a class, having a type as a class. So SQL type DB is equal to this dot get readable database, because we want to just read the data and we want to display it. So either you have to call get readable or get writable. Get readable means you are reading the data, we are not going to change any data. If there is change in the data or change in the values, we want to call get writable. So either you can call get readable, get writable, depending on the task you need. After that there is a cursor. Cursor is equal to db cursor, the object is a cursor, is equal to db.query. Now inside the query we want to pass the table names, we want to pass the column names, and selection is null. Selection argument is null, group by null, having null, and we want to provide a sort order. So if you want to formulate a query, you can give the values also. Suppose you want to select a particular columns, you can give a selection arguments or selection arguments, or if you want to give up any where clause or group by clause or having clause, you have to provide the particular values. Now I want to retrieve the values one by one. So at the first location of the cursor dot move to the first, this is the method we want to call, and we are using do loop, do while. Now we have created user class, so user is equal to new user. Now user dot set username is equal to cursor dot get string of cursor dot get column index column name. Now how it is going to retrieve? First the get column index method is called of the cursor. We want parameter as a column name, so this column name is retrieved. This is set to the cursor, so cursor dot get string. We want retrieve string at a column name value, and this is set to the user. So already we have seen the getter and setter methods of this user class. Similarly you can put up the password. So here we are going to set the values of user class. Now user list, this is the list dot add, we want to add the user class, and this is the while loop, do while we have used. Now till the last move to the next means we want to call the loop till the last method, sorry, till the last record. So move cursor dot move to the next, so one by one you are going to call the records. So cursor dot close and db dot close, and after that we want to return this user list. So this is a type as a return type. So here is the code for database connection and for insert, update, delete and select. Now this is all done with the database. Now once this is over, we want to call this into another Java class, and that Java class contains the activity. Now we want to create a class for login. and that login contains username and password, and that should be matched with the database. Now already we have seen how we are going to create a databases in the SQLite database helper database handler class. We have seen that. Now this class and these functions we are going to use in the user login user class. Now the class name is login user and extends this app compact activity, or extends the activity. Now this is the SQLite database handler. Now this class is already we have created over here. Now this class, I have created the object of this class. Now it detects username and password, buttons are login and register. Again we have created one read text. Now first we have to set the layout. So activity r.layout, r.layout.activity login user. Now when you see this login user activity, you will find that there is the username table, there is a username, and there is a password edit text, and there is one button for the login, and there is one button for new user. Now we have to initialize these variables. That means we have to initialize the controls what we have drag and drop. After that, db.sqlite.databasehandler, we have to initialize this database class. So sqlite db handler is equal to new sqlite db handler and context this. Now after that, if there is a new register, we want to create a user. So it is going to take the class of the create user. So this is the create user class. So after that, we will see that this class also when we are going to insert the values. Now if the user clicks on the login button, we have called set on click listener. Now we have taken username and password values from the text boxes, and after that we have called check user. Now this method is present in the class SQLite database handler. This is the SQLite database handler, and this method, that is check user, this method is called in the class check login user. So check, it is a method present in the class SQLite database handler. Now when you are calling this method, we want to pass two parameters. So these two parameters should be passed. These two parameters are string username 1 and password 1. Now it contains result. If it is true, that means the record is added successfully. The record is retrieved successfully. If there is greater than 0, it is going to return true. And if it is going to return true, then the login is success. Otherwise, login is unsuccessful. So it is going to check in the database. So this is not the hard code values of username and password, but this is the values from the user, from the database, and the database we have used, that is SQLite. Now this was the code for the login. Now suppose the user is new, and suppose the user want to create username and password, then we have created a class create user. Now here is the create user class. We have to initialize the database, that is SQLite database handler db is equal to new SQLite database handler. Now we have to initialize the variables, and on the click listener we have to retrieve the values username and password, and these values we want to pass. Now create user, it is a method. When you click on this, when just click on the control button, and by using mouse click on it, so just press the control button and click on the create user, you will get at the exact location of the create user function. Now this is the function. Already we have seen this function. This function is present in the SQLite database handler class, and this function is called over here. Now here we want to pass two values, username and password. Now if result is greater than 0, that means the data is added successfully. So toast.makeTest get application context.user created successfully, otherwise it is going to give the error for creating the user. So this was for the login, and the second was for the creating user. In the similar fashion, you can write a code. Means there is no need to write a code, we want to just call the functions, because already we have written the code over here. We want to call update user, we want to call delete user, we want to call get all users. So like this, you can create user, you can login user, you can update it and display all the values. So here we want to just call these methods like what we have called create user function. Now suppose I want to check whether the exact location of the database is Then first you run the project. Once you run a project, you want to go at the file system of the emulator. Now when you are running the emulator, so if you run the emulator then and then only, you want to click on the view, tools and device file explorer. Now here you will check the database. Now go in the data folder. Inside the data folder there is another data folder. Now inside this data folder we want to go at the application. My application name is my application 2. So com.example. So here we want to find our application. So here is the com.example. Okay. So here is the package name is com.example.myapplication. Now this is the package name, com.example.myapplication. Now inside this we want to go add the database. Inside the database you will get register as a database name. Now just click on it and you can save this. So click on the save as. Now where you want this file you want to store. Suppose I want to store this in the desktop, then I can store it on the desktop also. So I'm going to store it. On the desktop, so I'm going to select desktop and click on the OK. Now this file is stored in the desktop. So if you want to see this, you can see on the desktop. So file name is register. So this is the database file. Now suppose I want to open the database file, then open this SQLite browser. Click on the open database. Now from the open database click on the desktop, and in the desktop we have stored this as a register. Click on the open. Now you will get the register user. So this is the table name and this is the username and password. This is the column. So like this you can import or export the database also. Suppose I created a database over here by using click on new database. So I can create a database also. I can store it, and suppose I want to get this database into a table or into Android, then I can click over here databases, and here I can paste or I can drop over here. So like this, or I can upload the file. So either you can upload from the computer or you can copy the database out of the emulator also. So like this you can insert update data by using SQLite database. So this was about the SQLite database handler. If you have any doubts, any questions, you can put on the comments. You can try out this code, and if you have any doubts, any problems, you can put on the comments. Thank you.